Hello, good morning. Good afternoon, wherever you are. Hope you're all doing well. So today I'm gonna be trying puffy paint. It's basically three-dimensional fabric paint. I want to use black and white today because this is what we had in the house. If you were here yesterday, we were doing painting t-shirts. And do your research before you try a new medium, because when you're painting fabric, ideally you should be using fabric paint, not acrylic paint, because fabric paint has dye that adheres, or that it dyes the actual fabric, versus acrylic paint where it just paints on the surface, or it'll just absorb the paint more. So I will finish those shirts probably on Monday, because they ordered some actual fabric paint. So whenever those come in, I'll probably go back to the shirts. So yeah. Last night I played around and swatched a few of these fabric paints that we had around the house, and I tried different colors, and some had different opacities, so a lot came out. I checked them this morning when they were dried, and a lot of them weren't fully opaque, so you'd have to put several layers of those, because it's 3D, right, so you want to put like thick layers, but I tried to do thin layers to see how it would look in contrast, and it didn't come out good. So, yeah. I'd also like to thank Flying Bianca for the recent follow. Thank you. Yeah, so I can go to get started. What I want to do for today is I want to sketch out a pattern or design onto a small mini canvas. This is a 3x3, I think. And then try and do a pattern design with fabric paint to give it a more of a 3D look. I think that'd be cool. Because when the stuff dries, these are specifically metallic ones, so they will have a bit of shimmer. But they're definitely really glossy, so I think that'd be a fun look. Also, a thing to note, I just realized the shirt has tassels on it. And I used to have maybe 4 or 5 of these, like similar style with the tassels. And I worked at a daycare, right? And there's one trouble kid. Like, he came up to me and said, "Oh, these are cool," and he yanked one of the tassels off. I got so mad. He's like, "Oh, sorry." It's like, let me ruin your stuff, you know? Yeah. Anyway, that's all for now. I'm gonna go ahead and get started. So I'm gonna go ahead and change the camera angle. So, bye-bye, face cam. Oh, wrong dial. Whoops. Delete. There we go. I always hate seeing cords. It's just my mouse over here. Okay, so first, I did a little bit of swatching last night on paper to see how it hold. So I think for now, I just want to see how it looks. Let's go ahead and zoom in. And these are old, so these have been sitting on the shelf for ages, because you saw some bubbles came out. Because when you do strokes right next to each other, if you look, you can see, I should focus. See, I can still see that little bit of dimension. Like crevices within the strokes. It'll cast a bit more shadows when you're looking at it. I think that makes this one up more because it's very oily. See, when you do that, you can see the dimension still. It's interesting the look of this. I think it'd be really interesting on a canvas. Oh, that gloss looks cool. Because even when these dry, they'll still be fairly glossy. Yeah, I did these ones an hour ago. It's weird because, like, the bottom of the paper feels wet. Yeah. So, I just wanted to see how the textures look. Because, like, I assume it will pull together. But I think the glossy look, once it's dried, would be a very cool touch. It's definitely more mixed media type work. Because I know for me, I want to get into, like, sculpting. I think that'd be fun. Okay. So based on how the strokes look together, I probably want to do a rounded design. Because it's going to be hard to get, like, sharp edges or corners. I think with this, because it's kind of hard to vary like the width of how much product you dispense, so it's going to be a lot of straight passes. So I'm going to see if I can try and get I'm trying to think of anything else I can add, like, on top of this. This white is definitely having a lot more bubbles. I think it'd be interesting if once I get everything down, to run like lines across. want to try, like, drag either. You saw the swatches I made earlier. Like, so that's what it looks like when you run it through with, like, the back of a paintbrush. Okay, I think I'm gonna try drag the paintbrush to the center and do like plumes. I think that would look cool. Yeah, on my bike ride this morning. Or rather, there was a lot of smoke out today, so I wore a mask when I was biking. Like, just a simple surgical, like, single use. And when I was on the trail, or it's a paved path, it's not like a real trail, there was two downed alder trees, so there must have been a minor windstorm last night. And also, there was, like, a 500-foot, like, stretch along the pavement that had, like, just scattered bits of burnt branches and leaves. And I was like, oh, people are burning up trash cans again. But there was no trash cans nearby that, like, smelled the smoke. And also, so I was like, oh, then maybe there was just, like, a small brush fire. But I didn't see anything on the trail. So either, like, blew in the area, or someone lit something on fire. But when I got up this morning, like, sun was bright red. It's crazy. Oh. These wildfires are becoming more prominent now. Sad. I think it'd be interesting to see, like, how many layers I could put on this. This looks like crap. I wonder what this would look like if I pressed it onto paper. I'm gonna go grab some paper real quick. Okay, I'm back. Got paint on my headset cord, unfortunately. It's fine, because the stuff, as long as you wipe it off, it's okay. Like, the stuff doesn't dry instantly. You just have to let it dry overnight for it to fully set. Since it's three-dimensional, and you're not doing thin layers, it takes a long time to dry. Okay. So I'm going to try and like press some of the paper. This is definitely way out of my comfort zone. I usually hate mixed media work because there's so much like less control with it, I guess. You can't tell I'm borderline a control freak, so. Interesting. I mean, look at the texture on there too. Honestly, I really like how that looks on its own. Because that'll dry beautifully, the texture too. That looks cool too. That's interesting. I honestly really like this final result. Kind of want to fill in because there's a lot of empty canvas left on there. It looks veiny almost the way the texture is. I think it'd be cool to try, like once it's fully dry, to keep like pressing. I think that'd be an interesting concept. I do not like how it's getting all over my lovely nails. It's also pretty. I like how this one, let me see if I can pick it up and show. See, it looks like you can see the crevices. There you can see. And this one, looms are not as defined. It's really pretty. It almost looks like this texture looks very veiny. It almost looks like you put string down and then paint it on top of it, the way it's raised. I really like that final result. I kind of want to fiddle more with this paint. Kind of see. I'm cutting paper right now. Right now, I cut a triangle paper. And then I just folded it down the center. That way, when it stands, it'll be standing up like this. You wiped it off real quick. I think a cool concept. Just trying to think right now. To maybe make like a 3D like folded shape and then print with this, because it kind of looks like a mesh marble texture. Right now, I folded a paper so I can roll in it. This is really fun, just pressing the paper in the paint. And when it dries, it'll dry with that raised texture. It's kind of like how they do, what's this called? The paint dipping, I think. Thank you. at that. This is really fun. So I'm so quiet. I think it'd be cool too if I did this on a whole page and then use it as like a background for like a portrait piece. I think I'll do that. So I'm gonna set this one aside somewhere. That way, oh frick. That way it can dry like this. And by somewhere, I mean just on top of my laptop because I have no space in my room. So I think what I'll do is kind of like, you know, the Rorschach test where they put paint down and then fold the image in half. Probably something like that. So you can see the raised texture. I wonder, once this dries, if I can try and like run like more thin ink like down and see how it like falls in the grooves like here. Let's see if I can zoom. You can see the definition here. If I put ink here and then like tilt, maybe I ran it down, I think that would look pretty. But I definitely would not use this as a final. I want to add something to it once it's dry. It's interesting because the scrub paper too that I used to press, it left straight edges, so there's grooves that are straight. It's cool because when you look closer, the way the paper picks up the paint, it's interesting. It's almost like marbly. I really want to touch it, but I can't. Yeah, I'm thinking if there's anything else I can add to it. It's funny because like I wasn't planning on going this route specifically with the puffy paint, but I really like how it turned out because I can use it to build up another piece. I think that's why a lot of people like mixed media work. Like I've said before, mixed media or collage, you have to be well versed in like composition, building up your piece, making sure the elements you use will create a coherent final. I think this would be a cool background for like a paper cut. So I want to do paper cuts again. Yeah, I think this would be a really good background for a paper cut. Like, if I do, I kind of want to do branches or leaves. That way it kind of matches the veiny texture. Let me grab another paper. I have nowhere to put this one now. Yeah, the bottom is dry, so I think I'll just put it underneath my desk. And cross my fingers I don't clip anything. Okay. No, I just can't kick it. So I think I'm going to look up a reference of a tree for now. Whenever you're drawing from reference, always make sure you're drawing from a photo if possible. That way you aren't infringing on anyone else's copyright. I haven't done paper cuts in a long time. Doing something like this is gonna be a lot more complex than what I'm used to. Because last time I did a paper cut, it was an abstract piece. So, don't like that branch. Nothing that was like realistic or semi-realistic. No. That's disappointing. I could just use the back of the paper and flip it over. There we go. Okay, so now I have the base shapes down. Probably just gonna cut it out now. I'm gonna change the angle so y'all can see me cutting. Because whenever I cut, similar to when I might draw, I will always cut close to my face. Man, the white balance is whack. Sheesh. Okay, that's a little better. And when you're cutting, it's easier if you turn your paper. See how I'm rotating the paper around the scissor rather than rotating my wrist? Similar thing where you rotate your canvas. It's so it allows for a lot more ease in movement. And also, you have a lot more control if you rotate your paper versus your scissors. Let's see if I can change. Okay, that's a lot better. A bit muted. And not too washed out. No change, because I'm changing, or that was changing the picture mode on my computer, or my camera. It's hard to find or match lighting when you're doing traditional work to get colors that are true to life. It's very difficult. When you're cutting something that's more fine detail or has a lot of little edges, it's best if you try and cut out the details first and see how I'm keeping this larger piece for me to hold and grab, that we're going to be less likely to tear any of your smaller, more detailed pieces by accident. Oh, question of the day. What's your favorite art medium and why? I would have to say my favorite right now would just be regular pen and ink. Mainly because you have a lot more control when you're doing just a lot of variables. Because like pen and ink, ink usually dries immediately, so you don't have to worry about blending usually, or any unwanted mixing of colors. I think my favorite form of ink would have to be India ink, mainly because I like how it's waterproof, So if you want to do like a watercolor painting, you can usually go down to either like micron ink first or India ink. That way your outlines or black tones don't get mixed in with your watercolor when you're doing that second layer on. Also, just doing line work with brushes is really fun too. It's very difficult to get very precise detail with brushes when you're doing line work, but I just find it so satisfying when I'm able to do a pretty good line work with pen and ink. You see here, now I'm having or being forced to grab onto more detailed parts. You just have to be very careful when you work. Because it's okay if you tear like a paper cut, but then you can noticeably see the seam where it did tear. See here how this edge is getting caught when I turn my scissors or turn my paper. Be very careful not to clip. Like I've said before, everything you do has to be done with intent. So I usually don't gravitate towards mixed media, because to me, intent comes down to control. In terms of art, I mean. First one, yeah. Mind you, I have shorts on, they're just tan shorts, so. I noticed that my general style uses a lot more rounded edges, like my sketches and stuff. When it comes to nature, I usually don't use harsh edges. I'm gonna cut this edge off because my wrist keeps clipping it. I wanted to sit up when I work. The only demerit to, I guess, doing art at this desk for a long time is I don't have proper chair laces on my mini love seat. It's hard to maintain good posture, especially when I'm like crouched over my desk all the time. Thank you. Oh, second one done. Yeah, just toss it on the side. There you go. Yeah, so look at these textures. Oh, that's gonna look so nice. Oh, dude. That will look so good once it's dried. Maybe I can cut out like, maybe little flowers or something, or leaves. I have like these picture frames that are kind of boxy, but they have so let's see. I can probably sketch it out real quick that way you can visualize what I'm talking about. So, it's like a square box frame. And then it has little hooks on it so you can hang it like this on a nail. And this part is hollowed out. So the idea I had for these specific frames would be to put an illustration on the back face and then add like layers of paper and tape it to the front. Just like this, right? That's an idea that I'm working on. I think that'd be really pretty. Like, I just need to, like, I definitely want to do a portrait and then either incorporate paper cutout plants or like actual like fake fabric plants. But I haven't drawn people in so long. Yeah, no, I just want to sketch for a little bit. Yeah, the reference we're using is actually like a close-up of my eye. But I'm making it like a bit more hooded. Yeah, I need to do more sketches. Like, I need to get back into doing pencil again. Nose is too short on this one. Your nose is too short, but everything else looks alright. Looks like I got like this eye's way too thin. It looks pretty. This is no final, just sketching for fun right now. I should do more pencil. I really like doing line art. The only difficulty I have when doing like pencil is I low-key get frustrated when stuff doesn't match my reference. I also don't want to work on, like, my own personal drawing style. Because my favorite work is hyper stylized illustration. Like, there was a period where I wanted to learn or pursue, like, caricature. So I have a lot of homework to do. So I'm probably gonna end it here today. Sketching at the end was just sketch for fun. But to review what we did, we made these pressed pieces with the fabric paint. And then these, just to have some fun to see how different, like, edges would press onto the paper. Some stuck on there. Well, it sticks pretty well. It's only been sitting for about 30 minutes. It's already kind of dried. And you can feel the, or I can feel the texture, and it's really cool. And then find a large piece, a different texture. And then I cut out some leaf textures to, once it's fully dry, to, like, place on top. Make it, like, a more of a mixed media piece. So something like this. Yeah. So I'll probably put that down over the weekend once everything is dry. Okay, so that's all the time I have for today. I'm gonna go ahead and switch it to the normal cam. I really have to go because I gotta talk to my parents about something real quick, so I would go longer, but not enough time today. Dude, I am pink. Like, we got another heat warning in our state, and it's like, it's gonna hit 100 again. It's like, oh man. Oh, look at this fat sit. I don't wear makeup, so I don't cover anything up. Like, I don't vibe with that. But yeah. So, thank you for anyone who tuned in today. Really appreciate you popping in. I'll be back on Monday, 10 a.m. PST. Either going to dabble a bit more with this fabric paint, because I really like how doing the presses looked and came out. And then if my fabric paint does come in the mail soon, I'll probably go back to the custom t-shirts. So yeah. Like I said, I'll be back on Monday over the weekend, so I hope you all enjoy your weekends. Okay, you have a good one. Bye.